In today's video, I'll be using Legos to give you the most visual explanation and demonstration of horsepower and torque. If you have ever been confused by the difference between horsepower and torque, I guarantee that after watching this video, these two concepts will never confuse you again. So let's get started, and we're starting with torque. Now, this large Lego motor outputs 0.14 Nm of torque, and the smaller Lego motor outputs 0.03 Nm of torque. What's a Newton meter? Well, a Newton meter is a measure of torque. It measures how much torque is being generated. And what is torque? Well, the simplest explanation of torque is that it's a rotational force. It's the rotational equivalent of linear force. When you take this bolt and push it, you're applying linear force to it. But when you decide to bolt it down, you're applying torque to it. In both cases, a certain amount of force is present, but what's different is the direction of that force. So our Lego motors are outputting a certain amount of torque that we have expressed in Newton meters. One Newton meter of torque simply equals the force of one Newton applied at the end of an arm that is 1 meter long. So for example, if we take this bolt and use this wrench, which is 1 meter long, and apply a force of 1 Newton at the end of that wrench, the resulting torque present at the bolt will be 1 Newton meter. Newton meters confuse you? No problem, because torque can also be easily expressed in foot pounds. 1 foot pound of torque is equal to the force of 1 pound being applied at the end of an arm that is 1 foot long. So in this scenario, I'm using the stored energy in my muscles to generate torque at the bolt. Our Lego motors are doing the same thing. They're using the electrical energy stored in these batteries to generate torque or rotational force. And as we have seen, our large Lego motor is outputting more torque than our small motor. This difference in torque can easily be felt. If we install a small shaft into our motor, we can feel the difference in rotational force coming from these motors. The difference in torque output is very obvious, and the large motor feels much stronger, and it's very difficult to stop it. The difference in torque can also be observed. If we install a heavy attachment onto our motors, we can observe that the large Lego motor has enough torque to overcome the weight of this heavy attachment and can move it. However, the smaller motor doesn't output enough torque to overcome the weight of this heavy attachment and thus cannot move it. The convenient thing here is that these Lego motors can easily be compared to internal combustion engines in petrol or diesel powered vehicles, and even more so to electric motors in battery electric vehicles. Just like our Lego motors, the motors in modern electric cars use the stored energy in their battery packs to generate torque. On the other hand, internal combustion engines rely on the stored energy in fossil fuels to generate torque. But despite their different energy sources, all output torque at the end of a shaft. Both the torque output at the shaft of an electric motor and the torque output at the crankshaft of an internal combustion engine get connected to a bunch of different things, but ultimately their purpose is to drive the wheels of a vehicle. Now let's move on to horsepower. We already know the torque output of our two motors. Now let's add the horsepower output as well. And here we have the horsepower output of our two Lego motors. You notice something peculiar here. The large motor has more than 4 times the torque of the small motor, but it has barely twice the horsepower. How is this possible? Well, to understand how this happens, we have to understand what horsepower is. The key word in the word horsepower is power. What is power? Power is the rate at which work is done. In more simple terms, power measures how often a certain force is applied over a given period of time. You could even call power activity. It measures how many times you can repeat the same action over a given period of time. This means that power introduces time into the equation. When we speak about torque, time isn't a factor. We simply measure how much rotational force is generated, and that is our torque. That's it. But horsepower measures how much force is generated over a period of time. This means that torque is influenced by only one factor, the amount of rotational force. But horsepower is influenced by two factors: the amount of force and how many times that force can be exerted over a given period of time. Now we're going to attach these two blocks onto the shafts of our Lego motors so that we can more easily observe how fast each of them rotates. As you can see, the small motor actually rotates noticeably faster than the large motor. In fact, over a period of 1 minute, the small motor makes 275 full rotations, while the large motor makes only 146 rotations. This means that although it can't generate as much torque as the large motor, the small motor applies its torque at a greater rate over the same period of time. In other words, it outputs its rotational force more frequently. It's more active than the large motor. And because horsepower is influenced by both the amount of force and the rate at which that force is applied, the small motor can generate half the horsepower of the large motor with only a quarter of the torque. This also means that while torque can be felt and observed, horsepower cannot be felt in the same sense. It can only be observed. If we put our fingers against the shaft, we're feeling the torque. We're feeling the force against our fingers. When we're sitting inside a car and the car accelerates, we're again feeling the force pushing us against the seat. We can only feel the amount of force, and because torque is only a force, we can feel it. But horsepower isn't only a force, it's a measure of the rate of force. In the case of engines and motors, horsepower is basically torque multiplied by RPM, which means that we can't really feel it the same way we can feel torque. Something else that's interesting is that our small and large motors are pretty analogous to a truck and a sports car engine. Truck engines are usually physically very large. A truck like this will typically have an engine with around 13 liters of displacement. And from an engine of this size, you can expect to get around 450 horsepower and around 2,950 newton meters of torque. Really puts our Lego motors into perspective, doesn't it? On the other hand, a sports car engine will be dramatically smaller, but it will be capable of matching or even outperforming a truck engine in terms of horsepower, although it won't come even close when it comes to torque. In fact, these are the specs of an actual truck and an actual sports car. The sports car can outperform the truck in terms of horsepower only because the truck has a very low max RPM. The truck engine can't rotate beyond 2,500 RPM. In contrast to this, the sports car engine can rev up to 7,000 RPM. But the sports car engine can't come close in terms of torque. One of the key reasons behind this is sheer physical size. Often the torque output of an engine will correlate to its physical size. This is also true for humans, for example. A larger human will have larger muscles and will often be capable of generating greater forces than a smaller human. In a similar manner, a larger engine will have larger pistons and larger combustion chambers, which means you can stuff more air and fuel into this space, and you can generate more powerful combustions, which result in greater force applied onto the crankshaft and thus a greater torque output at the crankshaft. A truck engine needs massive torque outputs because it needs the massive force in order to be able to move a much greater amount of weight than the car engine has to move. On the other hand, the sports car engine generates its torque at a much greater rate, thus it generates more horsepower. And there you have it. I hope this finally manages to clear away any uncertainties you might have when it comes to horsepower and torque. As always, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll be seeing you with more fun and useful stuff on the D4A channel.